Let's go through some problems related to matrices and determinants, which is related to matrix addition, subtraction,
and scalar multiplication.
Here are a few two marker problems. Let's go through them. If matrix A is given, find 5A by 2 and minus 2 by 3 of A. So we'll work out one of these. Let's take 5A by 2. So first we'll have to separate the numbers. Let's make it as 5 by 2 into matrix A. And that is 5 by 2 into matrix A is 4 minus 1, 0, 3. 2 minus 3. So you'll have to multiply each of this element with the element of this matrix. So you'll have 5 by 2 into 4, 5 by 2 into minus 1, 5 by 2 into 0 is 0, 5 by 2 into 3, 5 by 2 into 2, and 5 by 2 into minus 3. This will get cancelled. This will get cancelled. So we'll get 5 into 2, 10 minus 5 by 2, 0, 15 by 2, 5. And minus 15 by 2. This is 5a by 2. Similarly, you can try out second part of the problem, which is minus 2 by 3 of a. Let's take another problem where matrix A, matrix B is given. They have told that O is a null matrix of order 2 by 2. Find matrix C. You have four problems here. Let's take one of them. Let's take second one. You have to find matrix C. Matrix A is given and this is O matrix. This is O matrix. So if you take second problem, A plus C is equal to O. First thing, we have to find matrix C. So let's keep matrix C on the left hand side, shift everything on the right hand side. So it'll be O minus matrix A. Now we'll do, what is O? It's 0 matrix by 2 by 2. It's a 2 by 2 matrix. That is, it has 2 rows and 2 columns. Minus matrix A. 1, minus 3, minus 4, minus 1. So this is matrix A. Now we'll do the normal subtraction. 0 minus 1 is minus 1. 0 minus of minus 3 is plus 3. 0 minus of minus 4 is plus 4. 0 minus of minus 1 is plus 1. So this is matrix C. So this is matrix C. Minus 1, 3, 4 and 1. Similarly, you can solve other problems as well. Solve the other problems. You have to find matrix C first. So put C on the left hand side and everything else you shift to the right hand side. That is when we can find matrix C. Let's take another example where we have to solve for x and y given this particular matrix expression. Solve for x and y means we'll have to figure out the values of x and y. Now we have x. Let's copy these matrices. Now we'll multiply x with both these elements, y with both these elements. So it's going to be x into 2, 2x, x into 1 is x. So this is one matrix. Then 3 into y and 5 into y plus 4, 6 is equal to 12, 17. Now we'll add the normal matrix addition. So it's going to be 2x plus 3y, 2x plus 3y plus 4, and second row is x plus 5y plus 6. This is, let's take the first element 12 and second element is equal to 17. Now we'll further simplify this. So we'll get 2x plus 3y is equal to, let's get 4 the other side. So it's going to become 12 minus 4, which is 8. Then we have x plus 5y. Let's take this 6 to the other side. So it's going to be 17 minus 6, which is 11. So now we have two equations. Now using these two equations, we have to find x and y. So what we can do is multiply equation 2 with 2. We can multiply this entire thing with 2 so that this becomes 2x and then we can cancel this. So it'll be 2x plus 3y is equal to 8. Let's multiply this entire equation. So it's going to be 2x plus 10y is equal to 11 into 2, which is 22. Now we'll subtract these equations. Subtract. Why? Because if you subtract these two equations, then 2x and 2x will get cancelled. 2x and 2x will get cancelled. So we'll be left with 3y minus 10y, which is minus 7y, is equal to 8 minus 22. This is going to be 14. Minus 14, which means y is equal to 14 by 7, which is 2. So y is equal to 2, right? Now we know value of y. Using this y, we'll get x. So let's take any one of these equations. Any one of these equations, substitute y value. Substitute y is equal to 2 in, say, we'll substitute in equation 2. You can take any equation. I'll take equation 2. So x plus 5 into y is 2 is equal to 11. So x plus 10 is equal to 11, which is nothing but x is equal to, by shifting this, you're going to get 11 minus 10, which is 1. So x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 2. Now let's go to part C and let's solve few 3 marks related problems. Find A and B if 2A plus B is this matrix, 3A plus 2B is this matrix. So using these two equations, we'll have to solve or we'll have to find matrix A and B. It's similar to other problem where we had to find X and Y. There it was X and Y. There X and Y were elements. Here A and B are matrices. But the approach is same. So 2A plus B is 2, 1, 3, 4, 1, 0. And 3A plus 2B is equal to 4, 2, 6, 3, 1, 5. So we can take this as two equations like the earlier one. The way we found X and Y, we took them as two equations and solved them. Similarly, we'll have to take these two as equations, right? Now, we'll have to ensure that one of these matrices gets cancelled. So we have 2B here. If you multiply this entire equation with 2, then you're going to get 2B here. Then you can subtract. You can subtract, right? You can subtract 1 minus 2 and 2B and 2B will get cancelled. Then we will have A. So we'll find matrix A. Same approach like the earlier one. So let's multiply now. So we'll get, you have to multiply the entire thing with 2. So you'll get 2A into 2 is 4A. 2 into B is 2B is equal to, now we'll have to multiply this matrix with 2. So 2 into 2, 4. 2 into 3, 6. 2 into 1, 2. 2 into 1, 2. 2 fours are 8, 0. Right? So we have multiplied. Now we'll take 3A plus 2B, copy it as is. 4, 2, 6, 3, 1, 5. Right? Now, we'll subtract these two. If you subtract this, this will get cancelled. 2B and 2B. So, now we'll subtract. What will we get? We'll get 4A minus 3A, which is A, is equal to. Now, let's subtract these two matrices. Right? So, you can subtract it directly like this. Or you can write it down in this form. Just to avoid confusion, you can write it in this form. And subtract it. So A is equal to 4 minus 4 is 0, 6 minus 6 is 0, 2 minus 1 is 1, 2 minus 2 is 0, 8 minus 3 is 5, 0 minus 5 is minus 5. So this is matrix A. So we have matrix A. Now let's find matrix B. How we are going to find matrix B? We'll have to substitute matrix A in any of these expressions. Let's take any of these equations and substitute matrix A. Then we'll get matrix B, right? Let's take equation 1, right? Equation 1 is 2A plus B. 2A plus B is equal to 2, 3, 1, 1, 4, 0. 2, 3, 1, 1, 4, 0. This is the matrix. Now, instead of A, we'll have to substitute this matrix. So, we'll have, before even you substitute, always use the technique. You have to find matrix B. So, keep matrix B on the left-hand side alone. Everything else has to be shifted here. That's the first thing we need to do before even we start substituting. So, we'll get B is equal to 2, 3, 1, 1, 4, 0. When you shift 2A this side, it's going to become minus 2A. Now, we will substitute. We'll substitute matrix A minus 2 times of matrix A, which is 0, 0, 1, 0, 5, minus 5. Now we'll multiply it. So matrix B is equal to 2, 3, 1, 1, 4, 0 minus 2 times of this. That is 0, 0, 2, 0, 2 5s are 10, minus 2 into minus 5. We'll have to take only 2, not minus. 2 into 5 is 10 and minus here. So minus 10. So now we'll do direct substitution. We'll get B is equal to, now we'll do direct subtraction. We'll get 2 minus 0 is 2, 3 minus 0 is 3, 1 minus 2 is minus 1, 1 minus 0 is 1, 4 minus 10 is minus 6, 0 minus of minus 10, so it's going to become plus 10. So this is matrix B. So there are similar problems in this particular question where we have to find A and B. In similar approach, we can solve other problems as well. Now let's take a problem where we have to find X, Y, A, B if this particular matrix is equal to this particular matrix, right? You'll have to equate both the sides. Matrices are equal. This matrix and this matrix are equal. Since both the matrices are equal, each element should be equal, right? Every element should be equal, right? So now we will find elements which have X, Y, A and B because that is what we have to find. So we'll take 3X plus 4Y. 3X plus 4Y, this is equal to, what is the first element? 2. You'll have to take the corresponding element, right? This is one thing. Now, here again you have x and y. So, x minus 2y, this is the third element. That is first row, third column. Now, take the corresponding element. First row, third column. What do we have? 4. So, this is 4, right? Now, we'll take elements with a plus b. So, you have a plus b is equal to, should be this element, right? This element and this element should be same. Should be equal. This element and this element should be equal. So, a plus b is equal to 5. Then you have this one also, which has a and b. 2a minus b should be equal to this particular element, minus 5. This is in second row, second column. So, you'll have to pick the element from second row, second column. This element, minus 5. Now, we'll solve these equations like we did in the earlier problems, right? You'll have to solve these. Now, to solve, we'll have to eliminate. Ensure that one of them gets cancelled. So, here, we can cancel x by multiplying this with 3, right? And here you can cancel a by multiplying this with 2. So let's do this. So we'll get, let's copy this. 3x plus 4y is equal to 2. 3 into x minus 3 into 2, 6y is equal to 12. Now let's subtract these two. Why do we have to subtract? Because if you subtract, then this will get cancelled. Right? So, 4y minus of minus, so it will become plus 10y. 2 minus 12, which is minus 10, which means y is equal to minus 10 by 10. Therefore, y is equal to minus 1. Now that we know that y is equal to minus 1, we'll find value of x by substituting y in any of these equations. Let's take the first equation. So, 3x plus 4y is equal to 2. So, you can take any of these equations. But don't take the equation which you have multiplied. I mean, don't take the equation after multiplying. Just take it before multiplying. So, you can take 3x plus 4y or you can take x minus 2y. Right? So, we'll take 3x plus 4y. So, we'll get 3x plus 4y. That is 4 into minus 1 is equal to 2. Substituting y. Right? So, you will substitute y is equal to minus 1 in equation 1. This is equation 1. This is equation 2. So, 3x minus 4 is equal to 2, which means 3x is equal to 2 plus 4, 6. Thereby, x is equal to 6 by 3, which is 2. X is 2. So, we have values of x and y, right? X is equal to 2 and y is equal to minus 1. Similarly, we find values of a and b, right? So, the equations are this one. A plus b is equal to 5. A plus b is equal to 5. 2a minus b is equal to minus 5. 2a minus b is equal to minus 5. To solve these equations, I have to ensure that one of them gets cancelled. One more thing. Here, there is already plus b and minus b. So, you don't have to multiply. You can directly cancel it. Right? You can directly add these. If you add these, plus b and minus b will get cancelled. Right? So, now, this will get cancelled. You'll have to add here. Because by adding, these two variables will get cancelled. So, we'll get 2a plus a, 3a. Is equal to 5 minus 5 is 0, which means a is equal to 0, right? A is 0 by 3, which is 0. Now, similarly, we'll find b. To find b, we'll take any one of the equations and substitute a. Let's take first equation, a plus b is equal to 5. So, 0 plus b is equal to 5, which means b is equal to 5. So, therefore, a is equal to 0 and b is equal to 5. Let's take another problem where we have to find x given this matrix, and this matrix. So, basically, you have addition of two matrices and the result is given here. So, using all of these, we need to find x. So, whenever you have such matrices and you have to find x, just concentrate on the elements which have x. So, first element here, and first element here have x. So, use only these elements. So, you have x cube plus minus 2x square is equal to minus x, right? Now, let's bring everything to one side. So, you'll have x cube minus 2x square. When you bring minus x to the left side, it will become plus x. So, now you can take x as common factor, right? So, this is going to become x square minus 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. So, now this means that x is equal to 0 and x square minus 2x plus 1 is equal to 0, right? We'll have to split this into two terms. Now, we'll have to further factorize this and find the roots. right? There is a formula to find the roots. To find roots of quadratic equation, this is the formula. Assuming that this is the quadratic equation, ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. If you have to find the value of x, then the formula is minus b plus of minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So we'll have to solve one root with taking plus and the other root taking minus. So plus and minus, we'll have to use both in the expression. In that case, you'll get two values of x. They are the roots, right? So now what are a, b and c? A is the coefficient of x square, b is the coefficient of x, and c is a constant. Coefficient means any number that is next to the variable. This is a variable or this is an unknown. X is an unknown, right? So a is a number. In this case, it's an alphabet. So this becomes a coefficient. So now we have a similar equation. What is the equation here? We have x square minus 2x plus 1. This is the equation. Now what is a here? A is equal to 1. And what is b? Remember to put the sign. B is equal to minus 2. And what is c? C is equal to 1. This constant is c. The number, only number is c. Coefficient of x is 2, minus 2. Coefficient of x square is a, which is 1. So now let's substitute values of a, b, c. X is equal to, let's substitute, minus b. Minus of b is minus 2, plus or minus b square. It is again minus 2 the whole square, minus 4 into a, which is 1, c is 1, divided by 2a. 2a is 2 into 1. We'll get x is equal to minus of minus 2 is plus 2, plus or minus root of minus 2 the whole square is 4, minus 4 by 2. So this is 2 plus or minus 0 by 2. So this is 2 plus or minus 0 by 2. So this is nothing but, you'll have to write 2 plus 0 by 2. The other root is 2 minus 0 by 2. Two roots are there, right? So since it is a 0, there is no value, right? But otherwise, if there was some other number, say there was some other number, say 3, right? Just assume. Then you'll have to make it as 2 plus 3 and 2 minus 3 and divide by 2. So you'll get two values of x. But now it is 0. So we can ignore. So we'll have only one root here. It's going to be x is equal to 2 by 2, which is 1. Here also x is 2 by 2, which is 1. Otherwise, normally, if instead of 0, if there's some other number, right, then you'll get two values of x. Now you just have one value of x, which is 1. So therefore, here, x is equal to 0, x is equal to 1. So these are the values of x. So I hope all the problems related to matrix addition, matrix subtraction are understood and clear. Thanks for watching. Hope this video was useful.